Baba Shemi Habashah to tell you what's coming, man. To tell you about the evil that's getting ready to take place down here upon the earth. It says, and he shall break it as the breaking of the potter's vessel that is broken in pieces. He shall not spare, so that there shall not be found in the bursting of it a sure to take fire from the hearth, or to take water with all of the pit. See, when the Most High brings his wrath down here, he's not going to have mercy, man. So you telling Jake to, you know, oh, just work from home or start a farm, that's not putting Jake in a position for them to be delivered. And furthermore, you know, this individual, he's doing neither of those. He's telling, you know, telling us to do it, but this individual has no video showing Jake how to farm or start a home business, which neither of those things are going to get you delivered anyway. But like I was saying, this just shows the ignorance of our people, man. It shows how oblivious Jake is as to what truly is going on out here. Jake think that they could be saved by starting a farm, you know, or just working from home, and all the hell that's spoken about in the scriptures is somehow going to pass over you. That's not how Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai gets down. This is 2 Ezra 15 and 10. It says, behold, my people is led as a flock to the slaughter. And this is a prime example of, you know, Jake being in that flock mind state, being led to the slaughter, thinking that they're going to escape just for, you know, just by doing certain things, you know, oh, having a business or starting a farm, you know. The one thing you won't hear these individuals speak about is, you know, push the fear of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. That's what we're doing. It says, behold, my people is led as a flock to the slaughter. And that's Jake. Jake has no clue as to what's going on. If you ever see a flock being led to the slaughterhouse, they'll just follow whatever cattle is in front of them, because they're cattle are herd. They have a herd mentality. So when one of them runs, they'll all run. They stay with the herd for protection, regardless of where the herd is being led to. So that's how Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai is describing you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, and the mindset that you have. You have no idea what's really going on. You have no clue that this devil is planning to exterminate you, man. What use is a farm or you having a home business going to do for somebody that has declared war against you, man? This man has an active war against you. He's going to send troops on you, and you worry about working from home or starting a farm. You need protection, man. You need to be delivered from your enemies, and the only way for that to happen is for you to trust in Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. It says, behold, my people is led as a flock to the slaughter. I will not suffer them now to dwell in the land of Egypt. Who's not going to suffer them? Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. But I will bring them with a mighty hand and a stretched out arm, and smite Egypt with plagues as before, and will destroy all the land thereof. So there's going to be a trouble, man. This devil's going to come down with that great wrath. He's going to try to exterminate the nation of Israel. We're going to experience that, man. We're going to be down here while these things are going down. When, you know, all these different plagues are hitting the earth. The Most High is not going to deliver the elect until, you know, that said measure is fulfilled, man. So the elect are going to be down here in the famine. They're going to be down here during the wars. You know? The deliverance is not going to take place until America's destroyed. Simultaneously as the nukes are dropping and exploding over America, the Heavenly Father's going to deliver the remnant of Israel from this land, man. So before that happens, you gotta deal with whatever comes down the pipeline. If you're going without food, you're in a situation where you don't have food, you have to trust in Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. If you're in a situation to where this damn devil wants to put you to death, he wants to put you in a guillotine, he wanna put you in front of a firing squad, you gotta trust in Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. You can't say, nah, okay, I don't wanna go in the firing squad, I'll take the karagma. You can't do that, man. And that's what we're telling our people not to do. Don't submit to the flesh and don't submit to this damn devil. Continue to trust in Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, regardless of what uncomfortable situation you find yourself in, man. This is Jeremiah 30, and I'll start at 5. It says, for thus saith the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, we have heard a voice of trembling, of fear, and not of peace. So you ain't gonna have peace down here know, goes to execute his plan. His vision for you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans is utter extermination. Why would he let you have a farm when he's trying to kill you, man? Why would he let you work from home when he's trying to put you to death? And furthermore, the currency that you're going to gain from working from home, you ain't going to be able to use unless you have the Garagba. But see, our people, they don't think like this. They just think that this is how, you know, the world is going to go on until the Most High comes back. You're going to be able to go wherever you want to, drive up and down the street. All the grocery stores are always going to be open, you know. Oh, I could just grow my own food, which that takes time anyway. For you to establish a farm, that takes time. You got to plant the seeds, and then the seeds have to grow and mature until they bear fruit. You know how long that takes? And even if you, let's say you do have an established farm, the Most High said he's going to send a famine down here. So how you going to survive in a famine? There's no rain falling. There's no water to water your crops. How you going to survive? And see, these are the things that we're telling our people is coming down the pipeline. And we're telling our people in these situations, trust in Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Because that's the only way you're going to get delivered. It says, thus saith the Lord, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, we have heard a voice of trembling, of fear, and not of peace. Ask ye now and see whether a man doth travail with child. Wherefore do I see every man with his hands on his loins as a woman in travail, and all faces are turned into paleness? These things are going to take place down here on the earth. A great fear is going to encompass you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. The individuals that are not prepared for these things to take place, which is the majority of our people. And the only way to get up out of this is to trust in Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, do the things that please him. That should be your main focus, not starting a farm. Are trying to establish a home business to escape the wrath that's coming down here. That's not going to save you. Verse 7, it says, alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it. It is even the time of Jacob's trouble. Who is Jacob? Jacob is your so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. We look this word trouble up. The word there is distress or anguish. So it's going to be the time of Jacob's anguish. Why? What's going to be happening, man? This damn devil is going to come down with that great wrath. He's going to try to solidify his new world order. Which part of that new world order, his agenda is to exterminate all you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. He has no use for you. He wants to have his rulership perpetually. And he can't have that with you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans alive in the sight of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. All right? Says, it is even the time of Jacob's trouble, but he shall be saved out of it. And the he that is talking about is the elect. Those that wholeheartedly trust in Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Those that are not going to bow the knee down to the image of Baal, or the image of the beast, or take the mark. Which, you getting a home business, that's not preparing you to reject the mark of the beast. You starting a farm is not preparing you to reject the mark of the beast. Because this man is going to take away your food. That's going to happen. But see, Jake don't want to hear that. Oh, see, there's a way out of that. You know, there's a way. There's something that you can do physically to prevent you from experiencing a famine. That, by the way, the Heavenly Father is bringing down here upon the earth through his agent Esau Edom. So really, this is the Most High's program, man. The Most High is just using Esau to bring these things down here upon the earth. But it's nevertheless, these things are commissioned by the Heavenly Father. So what's the ultimate way out? Trust in the Heavenly Father. Trust in the one that's bringing these things down here. Get back in his good graces and do the things that please him. So when the judgment comes down, he looks over you. Oh, this individual doesn't deserve to be judged. He hasn't done anything wrong. He's good in my sight. This is Revelation 12 and 12. It says, therefore rejoice ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil is come down unto you having great wrath. And when you look up this word wrath, the definition there is pretty much a drunken rage, man. Somebody that's just completely drunk, and they're mad at you. If you know any of you brothers that have experienced that, you can't negotiate with somebody like that. you can't reason with them and tell, nah, look, calm down. You know, let's sit down and talk this out. A drunk person doesn't want to talk. A drunk, angry person doesn't want to reason with you, man. When they get mad, they want to fight. And this is the kind of wrath that Esau Edom is going to have. He's drunker with rage, man. So you ain't going to be, okay, look, you just give me some seeds, or let me work from home, and I won't need to take this. You know, he don't want to hear that. No, you're going to take it, or you ain't going to eat. You're going to take it, or you ain't going to have no job. What decision are you going to make in that predicament, man? Are you going to bow down to the request of Esau Edom, defile yourself in the names, or in the sight of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, and do what Esau Edom tells you to do? Or are you going to stay true and pure to Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, and reject everything that this devil has to offer you, regardless of the pain and suffering that it brings upon you, man? What decision are you going to make? It says, for the devil is come down unto you having great wrath, because he knoweth that he hath but a short time. This time is almost up. If he doesn't solidify his new world order now, he won't be able to solidify it any other time, man. Because the kingdom of heaven is getting ready to be established. Once that's established, the nation of Israel is going to rule forever. So this is his last chance, man. So he's going to go all out. He's going to try to exterminate you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans through different means. One of the means he's going to kill you is by making you dead in the sight of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, by permanently defiling you with the Harachma. Those individuals that don't take the Harachma, he wants to put them to death. So he wants to have it to where the only Israelites that are down here are the ones that have submitted to the beast, that have bowed down to the satanic rulership that he's trying to establish, so he can have rulership forever. But we're telling our people that there's a way out.